By definition, monetary policy is changes in the money supply in order to achieve particular macroeconomic goals. In many countries, including the US, it's the central bank rather than any legislative body that controls monetary policy. The Federal Reserve System, or the Fed for short, is the central bank of the United States. The Fed has a very carefully crafted structure. After we examine that structure, I want to have a discussion as to the intent of the setup. Let's take a look. The Federal Reserve System is made up of 12 districts, 12 geographic regions in the U.S. Notice how much larger District 12 is than any of the other districts? This reflects the much sparser western population of the U.S. when the Fed was established. There is a 7-member Board of Governors whose members, once appointed by the President and getting Senate approval, serve 14-year terms. The terms are staggered with one appointment every other year, assuring that there is always a wide range of experience on the board. One member of the Board of Governors is the chairman of the board, appointed by the president to a 4-year term. Multiple terms can be served. Both Alan Greenspan and William McChesney Martin each serve for nearly 20 years. The 7-member governing board is a subset of the larger 12-member Federal Open Market Committee, or FOMC, which is the policy-making group within the Fed. The FOMC conducts all open market operations, or OMOs. What's an OMO? Well, by definition, open market operations are the buying and selling of government securities. We'll get to the purpose of OMOs in Episode 32, Monetary Policy. The FOMC is made up of the 7-member Board of Governors, plus 5 of the district bank presidents. The president of the Federal Reserve of New York has a permanent position as vice chair of the FOMC. The other 4 seats are served by the other 11 district presidents on a rotating basis. Time to think. Every aspect of the Fed's structure was carefully planned. What is the purpose of each? That is, how does this structure help the Fed do its job of managing the U.S. economy? Can you see any downsides to the Fed structure? In our next class, we'll have a discussion on the pros and cons of the structure of the Fed, so be sure to have your answers ready. Next time, monetary policy.